Ralph here. Welcome to True Power, Trumpet Fitness, and Fabulous Friday. And it is an extraordinary Friday. Anyway, you see, just like yesterday, just got in from a bike ride. It's beautiful out. It's cold. But it just feels great. Anyway, I'm going to make this short and quick, short and sweet. You saw the thumbnail. The reason I'm making it short and sweet is because you have homework. There is, yeah, I can't help it. I'm a teacher through and through. I'm assigning homework. The link down below, click on it, and instead of watching a 10-minute video, I'm going to give you a 5-minute video, and then you'll watch the 4-minute link. Okay? It is must-see TV, baby. Anyway, let's see what we got. Just walked in. Perfectly locked in double C's, run you through a little barbed wire, down to the double pedal C, all completely 100% in tune, centered, pure. Life's good. Anyway, you saw it. The best ever. Now, I stumbled, literally stumbled, I stumbled across this video yesterday afternoon. And guys, this is incredible. And, you know, I talked a lot about Bataillon being, you know, what I'm after, and Mel Broyles what I'm after. But to hear it done in the greatest brass section ever in the history of music, that Chicago Symphony with Herseth, this video is circa 1957. I was just a baby, and they were just killing it. Just killing it. You listen to this snippet from Symphonie Domestica, and you tell me, couple things I want you to think about. Tell me, not only Herseth, but all of them sound like Harry James. Ah, the sound is extraordinary. Absolutely extraordinary. And it's not just from Herseth. It's from everybody. The French horns sound fabulous. Jacobs, Arnold Jacobs, in his prime, in his glory. It is just, and the amazing thing, listen to the strings. They're keeping them. The balance is just overwhelming. And this is what I'm talking about. When I'm talking about pop, center of tone, tone power range, this is what I'm talking about. And guys, this is what's in my ear. So anybody that's listening to orchestral players today, you can see why I'm so frustrated with what's going on today. And don't even tell me anything going on today is even close. Not even in the stratosphere is what you are going to hear for your homework. Not even close. Okay? So, guys, not even close. But this is what I'm listening to. So when I hear Rolfs, when I hear Chris Martin, when I hear Bilger, when I hear Hooten, Manny Laureano, great players. Great players, but it's not what I'm hearing in my ear. That's not to mean it's wrong. That's not to say it's wrong by any way, shape, or form. To me, it's not as good. Now, here's something to think about. For to my way of thinking, Bataillon, the guy that I've been talking about, is the only player today that I've heard that could sit in that orchestra. Now, here's another thing to think about. If Herseth auditioned for the Boston Symphony or the New York Philharmonic today and played like that, he would not make the finals. he'd cover the whole orchestra. He wouldn't blend, especially if it was second, third, fourth trumpet. Wouldn't even make the finals. That's how much things have changed. Anyway, think Harry James when you listen to this. That is, Herseth made no bones about it. Harry James was one of his idols. Okay? There you go. Click on the link down below. Enjoy the Chicago Symphony, circa 1957, Richard Strauss Symphonie Domestica. Enjoy. Have a great weekend, guys, and we'll talk again on Monday. Love you all. 1, 2, 3.